Hi, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. Got another special guest here today to share with you guys, and we're going to share passion and enthusiasm. I've been inspired by this Bat Buddy, and I've told him so many times. Last evening, I was reading a little bit about a Dutch philosopher, Soren Kierkegaard. Some of his quotes and his thoughts sprung to mind. This person that I'm going to be trying to think of how to introduce, let me just share some of the quotes with you. He said, "Hope is passion for what is possible. Nothing ventured, nothing gained." You've heard that one. How about, "Absolute passion cannot even be understood by a third party. It's better to get lost in the passion than to lose the passion." Well, this next guest here on Behind the Mask is Jayden from the Cowl Vault. And he, if anything, is sometimes lost in the passion. And his enthusiasm just has blown me away and given me enthusiasm to do what I do. He doesn't collect quite as many cowls anymore, but he has taken what he's done and gone on to other things. And he's going to share just a little bit of his journey and his little snippet into his life here on our channel. And I appreciate it so much, Jayden, for you taking the time to do this. Take it away, Jayden.
I almost said welcome to the Cowl Vault. Thank you so much to Paul to invite me here on his channel. My name is Jayden. I am the creator of the Cowl Vault YouTube channel here on YouTube, where I previously and throughout most of my YouTube career, I call it career because it's just kind of like a passion thing that I was into for quite some time, would buy and review Batman cowls. The reason that I was so passionate about putting that on YouTube is because when I was a kid, I loved Batman. I still love Batman. Batman is amazing to me. He's my favorite superhero because of the fact that he's just human. He's just a normal guy that uses his billions upon billions of dollars to do good. But the one thing that always inspired me, because I'm an artist, was the costumes in the movies. The costumes were always what caught my attention. I always thought Batman looked cool. Didn't matter which version of Batman, whether it was, you know, Affleck, even Clooney, even the bat nipples. I was so into those suits. And it wasn't until I grew up a bit where I realized that people could actually purchase high quality stuff like this. I wanted to know more about it because I saw a video on YouTube. This is actually what started me on this whole journey of Batman cowl collecting and reviewing. I saw a video on YouTube back in, I think, 2015 of someone reviewing a Ben Affleck Batman cowl, high quality urethane, and it was custom, and I'd never seen anything like that before, and my mind just blew. I was like, I didn't know that this stuff was out there. I had no idea that you could get high quality stuff. Because all I knew was the Halloween costumes, right? That everyone gets at Halloween. It's like a half plastic mask, and it's like, oh, you know, that's not Batman. That's Party Man, you know? So ever since I saw that video, I was really inspired, and I was looking for more. I was looking for more on YouTube, and I couldn't find hardly anything. There was really no one on YouTube reviewing these things and showing these things off and just how amazing they were. There was a few people, like Paul here, that was showing that you could make high-quality bat suits with generic pieces and fan-made items and stuff like that to make your Batman costuming a reality or your Batman collecting a reality. And I was always really, really into that. So I delved deep into the cowl collecting. I believe last year or the year before, I had close to 30 Batman cowls. 30. I don't have that many anymore. I have about 7 because life gets in the way. You know, you have to do what you have to do, but I still enjoy collecting, and I still collect things from time to time. That was because I had to sell some stuff because we had a new baby coming. Here he is. This is Gunner, and I'm a dad now. Opening my mind to a bunch of other possibilities, I can make my son's Halloween experience so awesome. That's a little bit about me and where I come from and my background and my passion for Batman and stuff like that. And now I'm going to show you guys a little bit of my collection so that you guys can really see how my passion thrives. This is my office where I keep all my collection. And this is also my office where I make stuff as well. I've graduated from just the collector to now the maker. I design my own stuff now, and I offer my sculptures on my Etsy page. And I also, you know, do some physical stuff too. Not often, but I do some physical stuff too. But this is where I keep my collection and where I work. So this is my cowl collection. So we've got this Frank Miller inspired one. And then here we actually have one of Paul's pieces. This is Paul's Returns cowl. And I took some artistic liberty on it, as you can see. I trimmed off the scallops and gave it a new paint job to be more of that comic Batman. This is just proof right here of what Paul preaches on his channel, that you can take anything and make it your own. Then here we got this piece. This is made by another independent artist. Here we have the Michelle Pfeiffer cowl. This was made for me by a friend. Michelle Pfeiffer was like my first crush as a child, so I had to have this. Here we have like a Jim Lee inspired version of Batman. And then here we have another 89 cowl. The reason I have two is because this one here really looks like the hero to me. This one right here was made by a friend. And this one to me looks like all the promotional art that was for the 89 film. And then this piece here, we're gonna come back to it. This was actually sent to me by Frederick, who you just saw here on the channel not too long ago. He knows how passionate I am about 89, and he had acquired a big lot of 89 costume pieces, and he sent this to me. He said, look, I know you love 89, and this piece is from the stunt mold. That was just awesome to me that now I have something that is truly authentic to the film. And then here we have some of my suits that I've put together. This piece was a huge passion project. It's taken me quite a few years and a lot of money to put him together, but he is perfect in my eyes. It's got Keaton's face in here. I painted this myself, and it's the perfect topper for the suit. The suit I made wearable and displayable, so when I wear the suit, I wear that cowl that my friend sent me. But when it's on display, I like Keaton in the cowl, so I put this bust on here. And I have another authentic emblem that I glued to this bust so that it just looks awesome. And back here, this is the Michelle Pfeiffer costume that I'm putting together because I wanted to always put Catwoman next to Batman. That was always my goal. This suit consists of the bodysuit, the corset, I have the gloves in the closet and the whip. And then the only thing I really need now is a Michelle Pfeiffer life cast. And I'm putting that cowl on there, and then Batman and Catwoman will be together, which is ultimately what I've always wanted. I got this at Comic-Con not that long ago. I walked by it like 4 or 5 times, and my fiance was like, you should just get it. Even though I was trying to save for the baby and I was trying to be more responsible with my money, she's like, you know what? You need that. You're passionate about that movie. That's your favorite movie. When are you ever going to see this again? Get it. It was a lot of money, but it was so worth it. As you can see here, it's an actual piece of the Batmobile. And that's just so awesome. One more quick thing I wanted to show off. I saved the best for last. I said before, I run a YouTube channel called The Cowl Vault, and one of my subscribers wanted to help me out. Opened the box, and I actually filmed my reaction on my YouTube channel. It was the Life Cast. It was a batarang that I actually sent to Paul, and this piece right here. He sent a note, and he's like, look, you really inspired me. He has a YouTube channel where he reviews Batman cowls as well. He's got a lot more cowls than me now, and he's doing what I did. So I'm getting more people involved in this. Like, before, there was hardly anyone. I came into the picture and helped other people like him, the Gotham Collector, that's his YouTube channel. Now he makes videos too, and that's just so cool that I was able to inspire someone else to do something that I was inspired to do back then. So cool. Full circle. He sent me a note and he's like, look, I know how passionate you are about Batman and the 89 and Michael Keaton. I want to help one of your dreams come true. And he sent me Michael Keaton's autograph. And you can see my reaction in the video. I almost cried because Michael Keaton never really comes around where I live. I live in Canada. And he doesn't really come to a lot of the events here because we don't have a lot. Like, I'm in the Edmonton area, not like Toronto. Toronto is really where all the big celebrities go, and I don't travel a lot. So I don't think I'd ever meet him, ever. I still to this day don't think I will ever meet him and that I will never get that autograph, ever. And I wanted it so bad. And my friend sent this to me and he's like, here you go, man. I wanted you to have this. I had an extra one and I think that you would really appreciate it. So that's a little bit about me, guys. Thank you so much, Paul, for having me on your channel. I tried to keep this video under 10 minutes, it's just really hard because you start talking about things and you get so passionate. And anyone who's a Batman collector or enthusiastic about Batman probably has that problem where you try and sum something up, your passion, in like 5-10 minutes, and it's so hard because you just, something sparks something else and then something else sparks something else, and you're just like so passionate in that moment. Even if the people you're talking to are just like, they don't get it, you get it, and you want them to understand just how passionate you are. So thanks, Paul. Can't wait to see what you do next.
That was awesome. Thank you, Jayden. So as Soren Kierkegaard would say, nothing ventured, nothing gained. A venture was made by Jayden, and he made a great gain. And he's living his life in, I think, a more thorough way now. He's got less cowls, but hey, he's got the Cowl Vault for him. And he's got a baby, a wife, a full rich life as an artist. And I guess I can kind of relate to that. So Jayden, thank you so much for taking the time to be a guest on this channel. And once again, thank you for helping me when I tried to venture to get over the 1,000 and up to where I'm almost 1.5 times that now. And who knows what the future holds. Hey, but thanks for bringing your people over here. I hope a few of my people can go over to your spot and just be familiar with your passion. Thanks, Jayden. I appreciate it. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One, and this is Behind the Mask. Let's bring our passions together here and make this the place that sets the example for the Batman costume hobbyist enthusiast.